Ignorance is a company's most expensive commodity. And Disney is discovering it abounds at Lucasfilm. Here's the story.
You will never find the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Welcome back to the Cantina. Please remember the rules. Tip the working bartenders 20%. No droids, bounty hunters, no Raylos, no Ray Nobodies, no Ray Palpatines, no Disney canon fans of any kind, no any of that. Don't piss off the bouncers, they're Wookiees and Deveronians, and I have to pay for the damage they do because it doesn't come out of their paychecks. Anyway. Want to talk a little bit about Itchy's latest blog, or what Lucasfilm employees don't know about the original trilogy? So, I believe this was on one of the making of documentaries on the 4K package for The Rise of Palpatine. Skywalker, and I'm not going to name names. I will leave Itchy's blog in the description here. I will, for sure. I want you guys to watch just that part. Because it says a lot about why Lucasfilm has dropped the ball on Star Wars. And it scares me for anything else they attempt. In order to get the Death Star wreckage on Exegol, whatever the fuck planet that is. It sounds like something a baby would say. Not a Star Wars name. wait. Just wait. So they go in and look at the model of Death Star 2. And they're looking at the trenches. And, you remember that line that goes to the middle. That was where the ship docked. Okay. I believe that line they're pointing at, and one of them is saying that's where Luke did his trench run. All right, first off, that's the line on the side axis, right? That's the docking bay. That's the thing that bisects south and north on the sphere that is the Death Star. Second of all, it's Death Star 2. Okay, what's my point? My point is, we have a bunch of people from the story group, Pablo Hidalgo, to the people that are working on a lot of the product, the practical sets, the animation, and the story, that don't know anything about the franchise. Okay? Now, if you were going to hire people, you were the president of Lucasfilm. Say, if I was president of Lucasfilm, and I just got there and I wanted to appraise my employees, what I would do, I would have a separate audit firm, like the Bobs from Office Space, come in and audit the employees. They would talk to each one of them, ask them, what is it you do all day? All right. What do you know about Star Wars? What do you know about Indiana Jones? What do you know about Willow? La-di-da, blase, blase. All right. If it came back, they were only 50% proficient, an employee was only 50% proficient in Star Wars lore, had only really only ever seen the original trilogy once, and had only really ever seen the prequel trilogy once, they would probably be let go. See, this is why I have a problem with people working for a franchise that is so beloved and don't love it. Hal Hinkle doesn't love Star Wars. You can tell. He thinks it's a political cuddle with which to hit his imagined enemies on with. Pablo Hidalgo hates Star Wars. Hates it. Hates it. If you look at all of his old tweets, you could just see he hated the prequels. He hates George Lucas. Those would probably be two of the first people to go. Okay? It's not like, in my opinion, it's not like Dave Filoni, Leland Chi, and Jon Favreau should be the only ones that know everything there's to know about Star Wars. Every fucking person in that organization that works on that franchise, or Indiana Jones, or Willow, should know everything there is to know about it. I would expect at least 75% knowledge. And that's a strong middle C. That's barely treading water. A C, you know, I would look around and saying, all right, is there a redundancy in this department? Who can we let go then? And the C grade would go. Why? Because loving Star Wars is something you would think would be natural for a person that worked at Lucasfilm. And yet, when you watch this video, and I want you to watch it, and go to the time spot that Itchy says to, they don't love it. How would you know? First off, why would you look at the horizontal axis, that big wide thing there, trench, that docking bay, the horizontal axis on Death Star 2 and go, that's the trench that Luke blew down. And you're working on Star Wars. Now, maybe he was stoned. Maybe he'd been doing magic mushrooms. You know, I don't know. But you should pretty much be fucking familiar with the first three fucking movies if you're going to fucking work on fucking Star Wars. Sorry for dropping F-bombs. Don't you think? Jon Favreau wonders why he's having trouble. The investors wonder why Lucasfilm isn't making any money. I know more about Star Wars than the people who wrote the fucking stories to the news shit. All right? I know more about it. My dog, who just passed away, knew more about it than the people working on this. Yet, for some reason, they're there. And they don't love it. They don't care about it to them. And you can tell by the way they're talking, it's just a goddamn job. You know, where the problem is these people are so nihilistic. Star Wars is not for nihilists. It's not for them. And they seem to think it is, and it's not. And, you know, the money guys coming in and freaking out at the garbage being dumped out on the market by the story group, by the people that work on the franchise at Lucasfilm, freaking out about it, are showing them that nihilism, I don't care, it doesn't matter anyway, don't sell anything. What it does, it makes fans not buy the product. There's a shock. We're producing nihilistic shit. People don't like it. I don't understand. They must be racist, homophobic bigots. No, you're a nihilist. You're a bigot. You're a misandrist. You're a heterophobe, a Christophobe, whatever a phobe. And you've created a pile of shit no one wants. And I've said this before, after watching just that little part. If you're an artist and you don't throw your whole heart, your whole soul, everything that you are into your creations, you're going to fail. You're going to fail. Great art is visceral. It comes from the very bottom of your soul and it rises up. It is the spark of divinity in every artist that drives many mad. And yet we have these people who can draw pretty animate shit, who compile lists of notes, who don't give, and who think they're storytellers and they're artists, who don't give two shits about anything but themselves and how they can manipulate everybody around them to believe their kind of shit. I mean, and that's what we've got in Star Wars right now. And that's why we're hearing these rumors. That's why it appears Kennedy is creating her own little new little studio and hasn't been involved with the franchise in a long time. The Rise of Skywalker is the pinnacle of, well, it tries desperately and fails to be the answer to the Last Jedi. People who say it was a big fuck you, well, it wasn't. Luke's still dead. Nothing that Kylo Ren did should have been made him redeemable. All right. It was a shitty movie, and it was a shitty answer to an even shittier movie, which was, you know, the sequel to an even shittier movie. TFA. This whole Disney trilogy, watching the people that worked on it, talking to them, has been nothing but a trip down down into the pits of nihilistic hell for anybody who's a real Star Wars fan. Read Itchy's blog. Watch that part of the video he points out. Let me know in the comments what you think. This is Steph signing out.